Lucina Yue, and welcome to my lecture recital today. I'm going to introduce one of Chinese most famous classical pieces, High Mountain and Flowing Water. I would like to introduce the origin of this work and its importance to Chinese music. Among the Guzheng repertoire, the Zhejiang, Henan, and Shandong genres all have a piece called High Mountain and Flowing Water. I will compare the similarities and the difference in melody, charm, origin, and technical details among the six versions of the three genres and perform the three genres. First, let's see the most famous story of Chinese music. Bo Ya was a famous qin player, both a master performer and a composer, and was respected as qin immortal. Zhong Ziqi was a woodcutter. The two met in common. Then Bo Ya was playing the qin in Lie Zi Tang Men. Bo Ya was good at playing the qin, and Zhong Ziqi is good for listening. When Bo Ya plays the qin amid high in the mountains, Zhong Ziqi said, "How good, the mountains are as tall as Tai Mountain." Bo Ya plays the flowing water, Zhong Ziqi says, "How good, sounds like a river flowing." Zhong Ziqi can get everything that Bo Ya plays. The same palette is also recorded in Lü Shi Chun Qiu, but this book has an extra ending. When Zhong Ziqi died, Bo Ya snatched the qin and cut off the strings. He never played the qin again. He thought no one in the world was worth of him to play qin anymore. There is an idiom in Chinese called Bo Ya Jue Xian, which comes from this, because Lü Shi Chun Qiu is not an official history. The story of Bo Ya Jue Xian may not be accurate, but this far research ending means that the Chinese people value their confidence. It is written in Warring State period, Zhangguo Shiqi. A scholar will die for his bosom friend, Shi Wei Zhi Ji Zhe Si. The ancient attached great importance to friendship. This is why the story of High Mountain and Flowing Water has become an origin and supreme statute in Chinese music history. If you are interested in Chinese culture, you will find mountain and water everywhere in Chinese literary and artistic works. The analogs of Confucius' Lun Yu says, "The benevolent loves mountain, the wisdom loves water." Mountains are describable for the benevolent who are always steady like the immovable mountains and enjoy the serenity in longer years. Water are desirable for the wisdom who are constantly changeable like the flowing water and tasting more joy of living. 仁者要山, 智者要水. Mountain and water represent the spiritual realm that Chinese people pursue, the unity of nature and human. 天人合一. At the same time, the mountain, river, and nature are also the last refuge. And we are going to talk about here is Zheng. In the Qin Dynasty, Fu Xuan's Zheng Fu mentioned, Zheng is a tool of benevolence and wisdom. Not only that, but the shape of the Zheng also has structure of Yue Shan Mountain and Long Qi Lake. The musical instrument Zheng is naturally inseparable from mountain and water. Benevolence and wisdom, Zheng nai ren zhi zhi qi. The Zheng is turned according to the pentatonic scale. It originally had 12 strings in the Tang Dynasty. It was fixed to 13 strings. It was introduced to Japan and was named Koto. The name Koto refers to the basic techniques of the thumb and the middle finger of Zheng. We call the middle finger inward is Go, the thumb inward is Tuo. So the Koto are the most common basic techniques of Zheng and are used in every piece of music. The interval of Go Tuo is an octave. So in Chinese music, the octave interval often appears and in the most common harmony pattern in the pentatonic scale. This octave pattern is best at depicting echoes and harmonies. I will discuss the six versions of the three major genres, each using the Go and the Tuo. Next, let's overview the three major genres and six versions. The six most common exciting genres and six versions of high mountain and flowing water are Zhejiang Shengrou, Lou Shuhua, Generative, and Wang Xunzhi, Genealogy, Chuanpu, Henan Shengrou, Wang Xingwu, Genealogy, Cao Dongfu, Genealogy, Shandong Shengrou, Gao Zicheng, Genealogy, and Li Lianjun, Genealogy, Zhao Yuzhai, Performing Skull, Cao Zheng Notation. So if you are familiar with Chinese music, you should know that Chinese and Western music are internally different system. Classical and traditional Chinese music does not have the composer's name, and the music is passed down through oral transmission and demonstration by teachers and students, 口传心授. As each piece of music secretariat, inheritors will add their changes and become their own versions. The complication of the six major versions of high mountain and flowing water music score from these three significant genres occurred at the National Guzheng Teaching Materials Conference in Xi'an in August 1961. At that time, Mr. Cao Zheng was teaching in Xi'an and invited Guzheng masters from all over the country, such as Shandong Guzheng Shengrou, Henan Guzheng Shengrou, Shanxi Shengrou, Kejia Caozhou, Caozhou Shengrou, and six significant Shengrou gathered in Xi'an. In the meeting, each Guzheng player from each Shengrou participating to submit performance scores as teaching material to be used by major professional college and universities. This meeting identified works from each primary genre. Although at that time the word genre was not used for describe it, the works represented in various places can prove it. 1961年在陕西西安召开的全国古筝第一次会议确定了流派，请各大流派的宗师提供乐谱，这就是乐谱的来源。 Let's see, talk about the details of the six versions. So the High Mountains and Flowing Water by Zhejiang Shengrou, performed and revised by Lou Shuhua. This song is popular in Hangzhou, Zhejiang. It was initially a flute music played by Monk Xuling, Xuling He Shang, of the Guandi Temple in Yuzhao Town, Tonglu Country, Zhejiang, for use in water and land routes, 水路道场. It was late transferred to Zheng music by Mr. Wang Xunzhi, spread to Beijing in 1930s through Mr. Cheng Wujia, and then by Mr. Lou Shuhua, Integration, Reversion, and Passing Down. The Guzheng master Cao Zheng wrote an annotation in How to Play the Guzheng. This ancient piece not only simulates nature, but also express emotion. In terms of style, it means characteristic are clear, strange, light, and elegant. Qing, qi, dan, ya. In terms of music form, it does not fall within the structure scope of Da Ba Ban in Henan and Shandong. Particular emphasis should be placed on mainly playing clear part and avoiding noise techniques when playing this ancient music. 弹奏这首作品的时候，切忌繁杂，要以简单清淡为主。The next version is A Genealogy of Zhejiang Xiangrou by Wang Xunzhi. Zhejiang Xiangrou was rebuilt when the People's Republic of China was established. The version was recreated by Wang Xunzhi and his students who were in Shanghai Music Conservatory, and each student had a different versions. Wang Xunzhi of the Zhejiang Xiangrou passed down the genealogy of high mountain and flowing water, divided into the high mountain and the flowing water section, 分高山和流水两段. This version is based on the clearing of Lou Shuhua's version, which has one more flowing water passage than the original piece. The mountain selection starts with a double octave, 双八度, and the falling water section is many up and down glissando. It's a flowing water of Guqin, Guqin de Liu Shui. There are 72 rows, 72 guanfu. The flowing water on the Guqin has no melody. Still, in the high mountain and flowing water recomposed by Mr. Wang Xunzhi of the Zhejiang Xiangrou, the melody used in flowing water passages based on the main notes of the flute melody played by Ma Xulin. 就是古筝部分的主旋律它是根据乐曲的主旋律来的，但是古琴的没有。 Mr. Wang Xunzhi guided the student to use technique acceptable to modern people using double octaves and tone contrast to express the echo of the valley, particularly to show the majesty of the mountain, horizontally using long melody lines to show the endlessness and the breeze of the mountain aboard man. It also used a unique pentatonic characteristic of Guzheng to display the majestic mountains and the gurgling water vividly. Place your feeling on the scenery and blend the scenes. It is worth mentioning that since the flowing water part is the second creation guided by Mr. Wang's student, even if they are from the same genre, each student's version will have subtle difference. Still, the main notes sound is almost the same, but some sentences are at different pitch location. 尽管他们的旋律大同小异，但是有可能会在不同的音高区域，因为即使是同一个流派，他们的学生，每个学生有自己不同的创新，不同的版本。 Then the unique features of the Zhejiang versions of the Czech are 提弹。 What is 提弹？ 提弹名提着弹。Then wear the nail on the inside of your finger, 指甲内带，就像我现在一样，指甲戴在里面。Double octaves and chain and string often, 双八度经常颤弦。The second degree of the musical scale will most likely by 银 and 颤，二度多银颤。二度就是我们常说的 re， the fourth degree of musical skill cannot follow the standard pitch and must be slightly raised. Situation. Play the bow with both hands, 双手弹奏. And large sections of glissando are played to express flowing water. 大段的刮奏表现流水. At the end of the mountain passage, the patimento and some vibrato, 滑音 and 颤音 move from the big finger to the low octave area of the middle finger. A traditional feature of Zhejiang genre, like Jiangjun Ling in the Zhejiang genres, has similar low octave yin and chan. 就是在高山的结尾部分呢, 它的滑音和部分颤音移到了中指, 往常我们一般都是跟着大指走的, 这是一个特点。 Some special notes. The flavor of Miss Lou Shuhua's version is authentic with Henan flavor. The rhythm of this is Chinese music genre. 因为娄淑华是河南人，所以她演奏的这首乐曲是带有河南韵味的，所以她的学生传下来的也是河南韵味。所以这首曲子虽然是一个浙派的。 曲子，但是是河南韵味。 Now we move to 河南商人. The 河南商人's High Mountain and Flowing Water is 板头曲 with 8花, 是一首加花的板头曲, 中板. This piece original name is Flowers and Flowing Water, 花流水. And it's fourth piece that must be played at the gathering of the musicians. It was remarked that there were an error in the transmission, and it was reported as high mountains and flowing water, which happened to be in line with the meaning of the meeting the bosom friend in high mountain and flowing water. 这首曲子原名叫《花流水》，是所有的真人聚会见面第一首弹的曲子。但是因为传的时候传错了，传成了《高山流水》。 反而因此有了高山流水会之音这个意思，所以这个名字就流传下来了。The two versions of the Henan genre has almost the same melody, but the difference in the unique scale used. Let's look at the technique. At first, Miss Wang Xinwu's 摇指 technique is excellent. 摇指. Mr. Cao Dongfu used 倒踢正打, and Mr. Wang Xinwu used Yao technique. So next is the climax passage. Mr. Cao Dongfu versions aided glissando with the left hand and octave playing with the right hand. Cao Dongfu 先生在高潮段落用左手的寡奏配上右手的八度演奏，但是王醒悟先生没有用这个技法，所以这两个版本的区别在于。 他们的旋律是一样的，但是用了不同的技法。So, 河南派高山流水的技术特点 characteristic of 河南 high mountain and flowing water follow technique. At first is a large joint force, 大关节发力. Then is a 扎桩 technique. And the pitch and method of the pressing and sliding, 按滑的地方特色. So in Henan, you can slide up directly and you speed sliding. 按的时候要非常快. There's two types of the 滑 in Henan style. One is glide directly up a minor third and slide up quickly. It's like 河南人讲话中. 那个滑音就是标准的滑音. Then we talk about the Shandong genre. traditional ancient piece of Shandong Zhengxiang Ru ditties with 68 bars. For this reason, the folk duo often use from the suites to express multifaceted musical imaging, such as the rhythm of qin, the wind swings green bamboo, the sand night and the bell, and the rhythm of books are suites of joint performance. In the 1950s, they were named High Mountain and Flowing Water and became popular nationwide. This is the intonation of Ms. Zhao Yuzhai's version of High Mountain and Flowing Water. So what's the difference between Ms. Zhao Yuzhai's version and Gao Zicheng's version? The Gao Zicheng's version only used the three sections, the rhythm of qin, the bamboo strings in the wind, and the silent night and the bells, but it has an additional introduction and ending. The music begins with a solemn chord played with alternate hands, depicting in the majesty of the towering mountains, and then use alternate hand to add hua, igniting the sound of gurgling water from the creek. 高自成先生的版本采用了三首小曲，琴韵，风摆翠竹，夜静峦岭，并且加了影子和尾声。开头呢是以八度和声为来表现山的巍峨，后段加了花，所以它的。 听起来会更像高山流水一些，也许这就是当年的什么山东派的高山流水，得名的由来。Now it's characteristic of Shandong genre, high mountain and flowing waters technology. Shandong genre, the most important thing is 小关节发力，小关节就是。 指尖的, small joint. So the sound is different. For Shandong's tuo and pi, they use pi at first, then tuo, tiao at first, then mo, ti at first, then go, 先劈后拖,就是先向外,再向里,先向 每一个手指头都是这样，和河南派不一样，河南派都是先向里，后向外。 Then is the 扎桩 technique, 同样和河南派一样用扎桩。 And the pitch and method of pressing and slide, 山东派的滑音是以回滑音代表的，和河南派不一样。 At this point, we will notice that the small joints of the Shandong genre produce the timbre characteristics of the genre. So why does the technique exist? This start with the chains in the wind. We were the nails. 为什么山东派会有这个不同的技法？是因为过去的时候带指甲，山东派是外带，河南和山东派都是外带。这个时候它先往外更容易，但是随着时间的变迁呢，虽然指甲都换成了内带，但是这个技法还是 流传下来，成为山东派的代表技法。Now the picture on the left is a way to wearing the nails in pipa, so you can find its external wearing 外带. And the right side is the current way to wear the guzheng, wearing the guzheng nails, so it's 内带. And I do have some nails here. If you want to try after performance, you can try it to use it. And just now, we mentioned that Zhejiang Xiaoru Guzheng nails have always been worn on the inside. 浙江派一直都是内带. Well, the Henan Xiaoru and Shandong Xiaoru changed from wearing nails on the outside to wearing nails on the inside in the history development. Now all Guzheng genres use inner nails. 现在所有的流派都是选择内带。An alternate else has disappeared. No person are making the white dye Guzheng nails anymore. So I take pipa's nails and as an example to let everyone see the difference between the outer and inner nails. The Shandong genre of pi first, then to, tiao at first, then mo, ti first, then go, are all based on the fact that it's more convenient to use their technique for wearing nails externally. Although the way the nails were worn changed later, this technique continued and became unique to the genre. The above compare six high mountain and flowing water versions from three significant genres. From this, the development of Chinese music is inseparable from the performer's style, and monotonal changes in pitch are closely linked to regional characteristic. But the most crucial point in the connection between Chinese music and Chinese culture, philosophy and ideology, 中国音乐的发展和变迁和中国文化的哲学还有当地各个地域的特色有密不可分的关系. In the Chinese world, music is not just entertainment. Expressing your feeling and ambition is the highest pursuit of Chinese musicians. 在中国的世界里, 音乐不只是娱乐, 最重要的是抒情抒志. I will play the three-piece High Mountain and Flowing Water. I hope I can find my bosom, 钟子期. different. Now, if he mentioned you use jia zhuang technique, use jia zhuang yao.
Thank you.
behind the nail.
Yeah, you have to you demonstrated the way to put it, this different inside and outside, right? But you didn't do that before.
No one do the outside nails
anymore.
Yeah. So you can't buy any outside wood nails.
Oh, you cannot.
Yeah.
So
it disappeared, completely disappeared.
Oh.
So I introduced now the V toward the nails changed.
Yeah.
But the skill is still.
Okay. And so those different genre you said. When did it form? What you know, how long history have been?
Actually the genre's word appear in recently like 50 years. But
50?
Since because the genre this word, before they never use this word, they do have this piece, have this music, but they don't have this word. After the 1961, the confidence of Guzheng, then the because Maestro Cao Zheng invited all of the genre's master, so they give they contribute their score. Then but in that time the genre this word never appeared. So it's kind of like Shanxi Qingzhong. It's almost disappeared in Shanxi area. So Master Zhou Yanjia did Qingzhong Gui Qing. So they rebuilt it.
So, okay, before that, people just played differently. But they never really put together, right?
Before they play like chamber music,
yeah.
Or they
so
play
the genre,
Chinese opera together.
The genre, the word genre in Chinese is what?
Liu Pai.
Yeah. So it's more like a school.
Yeah, I think about the school of genre, so Hannah decided to use genre because maybe there's some means in Xue Pai or Liu Pai. So I think Liu Pai is better than Xue Pai because it's art, it's not.
Yeah.
Can you explain about what school means in English, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like when she first.
In English, more like a school.
Right, I'm
yeah.
thinking like she meant that there would be.
Yeah, the genre usually. Is,
and they each had a different way.
That's
of
right,
music.
Exactly. Yeah. Genre
is that
means
what
it
is?
I think it is.
Oh, I thought that.
Yeah, I think to use. School is still better than genre basically to describe different it's a
different
style instrument
of music yeah
yeah different
mm-hmm.
instrument right
yeah
you can say the violin is a bowing instrument that is bowing genre
so it's kind of like genre is pingzhu genre pingzhu
yeah.
Yeah, new genre, we often like, you know, classical, rock, like
those. That's right, it's different.
Wow.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay.
It's different.
So I just changed the word from school to genre.
Yeah, I read it yesterday, I was thinking about it. It should be genre or school. I think it's more like a school in this situation. Because you talk about the same instrument, it pretty much come from the similar tradition. But a different way of playing.
Yeah. Brian suggests me to use school, but it's just last night, the last minute, so I decided to. Next time I can change to school.
Mm-hmm. Are there any other schools beside the Shandong, Zhejiang, and.
So it's two big schools, Beipai and Nanpai, North and South. In Bei is Shandong, Henan, Shanxi, Shanxi, and Neimongu, and inside Mongolia, Yatogo, and Chaoshan,
Jiayeqi,
Chaoshan Zhuge.
So that's the north.
South is Zhejiang, Fujian, Chaozhou, Kejia. So that's nine schools 茫茫九派留中国.
Yeah. What about the country like Vietnam?
Vietnam, I think all of this kind of instruments is all come from Tang Dynasty, the court hall. So because Tang Dynasty is the a lot of countries study in Tang Dynasty, so it's like Japan and Korea, they all have same instrument. Vietnam is same.
Similar instrument, right?
Yeah, similar.
Yeah.
It's called 鄂语琴,
right?
Called? 鄂语琴. They have some instrument looks like 鄂语.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
In Vietnam?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Maybe it's 握空号.
Yeah.
Because they are 平住乐器.
She said in Vietnam there's also similar instrument called crocodile. Something,
not
like.
Okay.
That's not.
I'm just enjoying.